founded a company. Company used to be a distributor for a Japanese sports shoemaker. This company grew with time, and they also started to manufacture sports shoes, equipments, and many more things. The company had an incredible success, and the products that they manufactured were all just top class. Now, the company's tagline is, or not just the products, the company's tagline is in fact even more impressive. It was so impressive that after a successful campaign, okay, how the tagline that came, in the year 1988, after a huge successful campaign, they came up with a tagline, and they still follow it even today. Because of this tagline, the company's market share in North America grew from 18% to 43%. That is a significant growth they had. And I have given you a bit of clue about the tagline. Can you anyone guess which company or which tagline that I'm talking about? Just try to make a guess. The company is a sports shoemaker. They started it, and now they are even the global leader now.
Nike?
Of course. So the tagline that I'm talking about is just do it. It's very famous, and the company is of course Nike. Now, if you take if we study the successful companies, you find that their taglines are very attractive, and they use it over and over in their company's promotion and for promoting their companies. And whenever they launch new product, they just come up with tagline, and they make huge money, and they're so successful because of one reason, that is their tagline. Now, let's take into the case of some other successful companies, such as KFC, finger licking good, right?
Yes.
Fiat, driven by passion. Accenture, high performance delivered. So, if you see all these taglines, they're all very catchy, very positive, and it gives us, it attracts our attention, right? Now, let's put it, the tagline, in an other way. Fiat. What if we say, driven by losers? What if Accenture would say, low performance delivered? Or Bank of America would say, lower standards? So what I'm trying to say is that if the tagline is positive or negative, it has effect, and it directly affects the company's fortune and ultimately to their success as well. Now, all these taglines, there is a pattern, and if you see, all are very catchy, right? And it plays huge part in the company's success and all the promotions that they do. Now, similarly, if the companies have their tagline, I feel that we as an individual can also have tagline. If not you, I definitely have it. And I try to follow it or do my task according to that every day. I got my own tagline, and I call it, let's do it. I've not copied it from Nike, but if you think, I don't mind, because if we can copy good things from others, I don't think there's anything wrong in it. So let me tell you some examples. Recently, Christoph told me, just now he said, right, that there was a humorous speech contest. Now, I know I'm a terrible speaker. I'm still learning. So there was opportunity to participate, and I just thought, let's do it. And I came up with the first speech. It went well. Then I moved on to other rounds. It was a nice experience. Similarly, when I first came to Singapore, I used to see guys skating in the streets and in the parks, and it was really nice to see them skating and enjoying their life. I was like, why not I try it? So I just went ahead and purchased the rollerblade, and I started skating it. And it seems to be, I really enjoyed it. I do it on every weekend, and it's really a good thing. I enjoy it very much. Now, so what I'm trying to say is, the tagline, if we have, it prepares us mentally, it gives us a power to think positive, just to get used to it, and if we are caught up in a situation where we are not sure of what to do, how to do, just go with your tagline, and it will prepare you how to do it, and it can make you prepare for any circumstances. So I would encourage that everyone must have a tagline and just follow it. It will help you get motivated and be very positive of your life. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Narendra.